r/AskReddit. What has not aged well? This one episode on the show Glee, Mark Salling, Puck, had a line in the show where he said that in the future, comma, I'll either be in jail, or dead, or both. For those who don't know, Mark Salling was convicted and found guilty of child pornography, then committed suicide. Also that episode where he was going to make a sex tape but got stopped because then he would have been producing child porn, yeah. Jared Fogle's Subway ads. The scene in Super Size Me when Jared is talking to children about his experience. Oh god, I watched that this year in my science class. Those shareable Facebook posts saying you are legally proclaiming that Facebook can't use your personal information. People were just sharing one of those type of posts all over Instagram the other day. And so many celebrities shared it, even young ones. Tom Holland shared it, but he's had a bad week, so I will let this one pass. Babies named Daenerys. Bill Cosby released a book called Come On, People. Later editions erroneously omitted the comma, making it Come On, People. In retrospect, that grammatical error may have been a prophetic one. Bill Cosby goofy voice, and then the switch comes out of the wing wang a doodle. Don't you know? Bloopity bloop bloop. All over the place. Clean the nice lady off before she wakes up and notices. Matrix parodies. For like 2 years there it was hard to escape the forced bullet time jokes in most media. There was an interview with Kevin Spacey working with kids and he said he was always looking for the shy kid in the corner. I was just blinded by the balls on that kid. Kevin Spacey, Baby Driver. That episode of Family Guy where Stewie is naked, running away from Kevin Spacey in a mall, years before the Me Too scandal, makes me think KS was known for that kind of thing in Hollywood. People who don't wear sunscreen kids. Or you could sit inside in front of a computer instead, can't get sun damage if you never get sun. For something that aged poorly really quickly, political comedy from just before the 2016 presidential election. Semi-recently I was hanging out with some friends and there was an SNL rerun from that October, and every single Trump reference is just dripping with a Trump is a joke and won't win attitude that it is tough to watch. A lot of stand-ups avoid politics in their specials because it usually doesn't age well regardless of circumstance. Sometimes it's unavoidable, like late-night shows that have to keep it topical. CGI from 90s films. The CGI on Terminator 2 and Jurassic Park still looks great now, but anything else just looks crap. Anaconda had some awful CGI and script. I think that Jurassic Park aged well partly because its creators understood the limitations that they were working with in 1993. Honestly, newer movies that overuse CG in an attempt to wow people age a lot worse. Avatar is probably the best example that I can think of. It was publicized for how amazing it looked in 2009. And Call of Duty. Black Ops made a big deal of using the same motion capture technology a year later, by 2014. When I watched it the second time, it already looked dated. There's a commercial featuring Bill Cosby about PPL going to jail. There's an episode of The Cosby Show where he drugs his barbecue sauce so a bunch of teenagers fall in love. Bit of a Brit thing, but Punch and Judy puppet shows. Punch is an alcoholic who beats up Judy for the entertainment of kids. Frowned upon nowadays. I mean, if you're going with British children's entertainment, there's the entire work history of Jimmy Savile. Career advancement. Working your way up from the mailroom is long gone. You have to switch companies to get any sort of significant raise. When you put in your notice for the switch, they try to keep you by offering a raise. Always pissed me off more because why am I now worth more? You should have been proactive and I never would have been looking elsewhere. Any reference to Hillary Clinton becoming the first female president in shows and movies. I remember there was an entire episode on Rory writing an essay about Hillary Clinton, then finding out everyone else wrote an essay about how Hillary Clinton inspired them in Gilmore Girls. Even as a Democrat, I'm like, yikes. In Britain there's a big televised New Year's Eve party every year, called Jules Holland's Hootenanny. They had a psychic on there who gives predictions for the coming year. And the year of the first Obama election, the supposedly famous lauded psychic said, Hillary Clinton, next president of the United States. No one has ever talked about it, but duct if they ever hired that psychic again. Oblivion's graphics. I love Morrowind, but the potato faces in Ted IV seriously throw me off. It wouldn't be so bad if the camera wasn't shoved up the nose of whatever NPC you're talking to. I think that's honestly the biggest issue with it, especially when you sleep in game and wake up with some a-holes from the Dark Brotherhood starting a conversation. Scariest thing in the game that. I wonder if there is a mod for a Skyrim-like dialogue camera. Minions. They used to be these kinda cute, one-off characters in a decent movie, then once Illumination realized they can beat minions to death and back and still make hundreds of millions, they just focused on minions and only minions. All the acceptance speeches thanking Weinstein. The whole cousins thing they pulled in the English dub of Sailor Moon back in the day with Iruka and Michiru, named Amara and Michelle in the dub, who were originally written as a lesbian couple. I know that lesbian couples in a kid's show would have been a big deal at the time that it came out, but looking back now, they really did a piss poor job at trying to make their relationship not seem romantic while also claiming they were related. Donatella Versace, honestly. I think she now technically qualifies as a vintage leather bag. Anti-vax kids. That grilled cheese I intended to take to work last winter and I just found in an old backpack in the back of my closet. The Japanese landlord in Breakfast at Tiffany's. Much of America's crumbling, deteriorated infrastructure hasn't aged well. Decaying bridges, roads, rail lines and railroad cars, water delivery systems that still use lead piping, inadequate highways that are poorly maintained, electric grids, etc. Revenge of the Nerds. My mother-in-law gave me a copy of Bill Cosby's Fatherhood when my first son was born. She actually meant well. Turns out Bill Cosby's advice on any subject seems suspect. All these animated films, TV shows that depict African Americans in a really offensive way, it's really disgusting to look at nowadays. Plus there are companies like Disney that have just censored any racial stereotypes in their old films and pretended like it never happened. At least do what Warner Bros. Did, put a disclaimer at the beginning that it was a product of its time, and even though it's offensive, one shouldn't try to censor the past. Whoa, you made it to the end? You're a ducking beast. I'll cut you a deal. Smash like and subscribe for more curated content, bruh. It's free and that's a great price.